in this August gathering, which I think constitutes a lot of very senior officers, retired people, the former chief secretary, also my education secretary at one time, Mr. Raghunathan, also there. The mayor of South Delhi is also part of this gathering, Mrs. Renu Mehraji. The book is in fact dedicated to her also. She has also been a great partner in the compilation of this book, as the book says so. And it's also dedicated to the memory of the mother of Shri K.S. Mehraji, Srimati Khajano Devi, who left for heavenly abode when he was 10 years old. And he tells me very fondly that she used to say that mera beta ek din DC banega. So I think her dream has been realized with his efforts. She must be feeling very happy that now her son is writing a book about the place where he was born. And so I must congratulate Mr. K.S. Mehra for compiling this book, because when I read the introduction, I became aware that the idea of writing this book was born when he was invited for a function in the India International Center also to discuss his experiences as an officer and for his role that he played for Delhi in various positions. And when he was planning to deliver what has been his experience and all, at that time when he went into the depth of his past, then only came the idea to him that he must write a book on this subject. I know, I don't know how difficult or easy it has been for him. I really don't know whether he's a professional writer or he tried it first time. But I also have an experience of writing a book, and I know it's a very, very difficult task. I completed my 26 years of my public life all spent in Delhi. I was born and brought up in Delhi last month itself. And most of you know that when I became a minister in 93, and I did successfully the polio eradication in 94. So one of my senior RSS Pracharaks, he visited my house in the early 95. And he said, Dr. Harshvardhan, I have come to just give you one small suggestion, that you must write a book about your experience of how you thought about it and how you did it. That was only in 94. And that very day, dream was born in the mind that this is from a very, very senior person, very respected person, loved and adored by everyone. And he has said something, I have to do it. But I know that even if a dream is born, how difficult it is to put pen to paper and then compile a book. For almost from 94, 95, that dream was born, and the book that I wrote, I could complete it in 2003, A Tale of Two Drops, and Atalji released it towards the end of 2004. And for many years, I used to write small notes in a diary, just trying to put some hints about some events that whenever I'm actually writing, I will put this there, I will put this there, I will put this there. So it's a great effort, because his dream was born in 2015, according to the book. And in 2019 itself, we are releasing his book. And I feel so guilty and sorry also. He has been visiting me for a couple of, I think, months now. Yes. asking me, and thanks to his patience that in spite of the fact that I couldn't give him the time immediately to do this job, I thought that he will find someone else, but I have to say thank you to him and express my gratitude to him. I remember very fondly that my first meeting, I don't really remember date and all, but 2008, towards the early 2008, he came to Delhi as a municipal commissioner. And I was a MLA in Delhi. That was my fourth term as MLA. And I used to take rounds in my constituency at 7 o'clock in the morning. All the 25 years that I was almost MLA, 20 years, till 2013, from 1993 to 2013, I used to take rounds in my constituency at 7 o'clock. So when I called him for the first time, in fact, I don't remember if I had seen him earlier. So when he came for the first round, it was like love at first sight. A smiling face, very cool person, very handsome, smart, very polite. I hope his wife agrees with me. And like, he was a very sophisticated, polished person, and very well behaved, very meaningful, and very committed to his job. Like, if it was 7 o'clock, he came at 7 o'clock with all his... It's a unique thing. When an MCD commissioner comes for a round to help the MLA or a former minister, or for that matter a corporator, he brings with him so many people, so many vehicles, that it's like a traffic jam everywhere, wherever he goes. This is the experience of everyone who has ever enjoyed a round with a municipal commissioner. So I think that was my first meeting. I don't remember when it was, but of course it was in 2008. And then I found him a very good officer, who really went into the nitty-gritty of things, did not make false promises, and would stick to his word. Whatever you demand, if he can do it, he will say yes. If he can't do it, he will say we'll find it difficult to do it and all. So I was also like understanding, if he can't do it, let's forget about it, let's go to the next subject and all. So I have good memories with him, and that was the time when 2008 to 2012, if something significant we can remember, is the Commonwealth Games. And Commonwealth Games were where many of the things which the Delhi government was in fact not able to do, the job was ultimately used to be assigned to the municipal corporation. That was the perception that was built at that time. And I can appreciate that, unfortunately, the municipal corporation in Delhi, in spite of it being a very, very powerful organization, and as Mr. Patnaik said, it was probably the second richest. I didn't know that, but it's news for me that it was the second richest in the whole country when it was undivided. And from 97 to almost till now, except for the 5 years between 2002 and 2007, it had been ruled by Bharatiya Janata Party. Unfortunately, what has happened is that when there is a BJP in corporation, there is a Congress or right now another party at the Delhi government level. And because of this difference or different political parties at two levels, corporation, it's in spite of it being a very, very strong body with very robust systems, it has had, it has faced a very stepmotherly treatment from the central, Delhi government. And unfortunately for the central government, it can't help the corporation directly. It has to help the corporation through the route of the Delhi government. And the worst of it, the people have seen in the last 5 years itself, when you got the extreme of that stepmotherly treatment in Delhi, when even the sanitary workers were not being paid, and even the money for the salaries were also not available. But in spite of all this, what the municipal corporation has been able to do is, I think, extraordinarily exemplary. And I would rate Mr. Mehra as one of the very good municipal commissioners that the corporation has seen, at least in the last 25 years, the time when I observed things happening in Delhi from the closest of quarters. I have been born and brought up in Delhi, and last 6 decades, I feel that in spite of the fact a lot of changes have happened in Delhi, but there are, I will not get into the details because my two senior officers and who have the total experience of their life, they have elaborated upon all that is written in the book, and also, of course, the various problems that the city is plagued with. But I still find that even after 6 decades, the problems that I used to see in my childhood, they are still there. And there is no end to the new problems growing. So the first idea, honestly, that came to my mind after reading this book was that if a retired officer can recall everything and then give some good suggestions about what needs to be done, how do you deal with sanitation issues, how do you deal with Yamuna, how do you deal with further with digitalization, how you deal with environmental issues. He has talked about climate change, global warming, so many things he has talked about. So Delhi has so many, I think, fine officers who are like, they have retired from service, they are like relaxing, or maybe doing some consultancy somewhere, or maybe enjoying their life with their children, grandchildren. So if somebody tries to institutionalize this, you can say, retired intellectual acumen of the people who served Delhi in particular, and who have seen the problems of Delhi on all fronts, from all angles. Because when you are in office, you are very tense, and sometimes you don't propose difficult solutions. Sometimes difficult solutions are difficult to implement. There are so many complications. Like, I know there were so many ugly portions of the Commonwealth angle, but you have very intelligently avoided all those things in the book. So when you are in office, it's difficult to actually do, plan, and sometimes even convince those who are at the helm of affairs to really implement them. But if a team of good officers, somebody can take the initiative and collect such people, and I can help in ensuring that a group like this, if 10, 15 good people, now they know everything. They have studied everything, they know everything, they know the problem. Now, a book on only how the problems of every nature will be solved, how they can be solved, the viable solutions to the solutions to the problems given by those who always served Delhi, who have the maximum knowledge, experience, vision, who have traveled all over the world, who have seen how the world has been able to resolve its problems. I think the for me, the good outcome of this particular function could be that if we can think of having a, because these days it is at least in my 25 years, I have felt that if there is a good quality brainstorming, you can get fantastic outcomes. You can get the brightest of ideas from anybody, not necessarily very intelligent person, from even a normal layman with milder IQ. Mr. Raghunathan will remember that we used to go to Qutub Minar. Not many people know. With 50 good principals, we would sit below Qutub Minar and from morning till evening discuss how through the education department we can make a perceptible and measurable change in the value systems of the children. And all that we did together in education, whether it was a value education calendar or whether it was a teaching yoga for everyone, whether it was creating the positive health education program through the children or the sports, making sports compulsory in schools, etc. So many things. They all were born out of hand, and the challenge that we posed before the 50 principals was to develop a program whereby we can make a perceptible change in the value system. And you won't believe that when we started doing that, because Mr. Patnaik has also been a part of that movement at some point of time. I think for over a year you were also director of education with me. You can recall all those things. And then starting from Qutub Minar, we had gone up to Kurukshetra. And Kurukshetra, we 21-25 people, we spent 3 days together. And Mr. Raghunathan also used to take lunch with us sitting on the floor. And we only brainstorming, only discussing. So if a good group of retired people forms in Delhi with only one aim, that we have to make Delhi really the best city of the whole world, we have to solve each and every problem, give the best solutions to it, because it will require radical ideas, radical solutions, radical approach, radical vision, everything radical. But right now, fortunately, we have a Prime Minister in the country who is very fond of radical things also. So any good things that we give to the government, they will be, that will not be too difficult to actually implement. So this came as a natural thing to me, because I thought if one man can produce a book with a good number of good ideas, if when we have hundreds of good officers in Delhi who have thorough knowledge about everything, we can really change the face of Delhi. That's I think something on which any one of you, whosoever is here. A lot of senior officers are also here in this gathering. This can start as a seed from somewhere. Maybe Mr. Raghunathan can take up, you can take up, Mr. Vivek can take up, anybody can take up. And once we started, I think in another few months, we should have another book written by some 10 officers. Chapters contributed by 10, 15 officers with practical, radical, thorough solutions. Everybody wants to change the face of Delhi, but of course there are difficulties. We know Yamuna continues to be like that, which it was 25 years back. We know the traffic jam is there. We know the unauthorized colonies continue to grow. We know the slums. We know the Yamuna bed. We know all these problems. You know the water continues to leak. I remember one chairman of Delhi Jal Board, he gave an interview to Hindustan Times saying that at least 65% of the water gets leaked. Somebody said 40%. And the leakage problem continues to be there, whether it is a organized leakage or a you can say systemic leakage, etc. So the problems are there. Though we have got the flyovers and the metro, but our other transport system and all is still in shambles. Bus services and all those things. So I would use this opportunity to appeal to all the good officers in Delhi to form a good quality. And you, I know you have a very good friendship. Like we have in our medical college, our batch, this batch, that batch, you also have this. My batch, like they are very happy sitting in his batch function. Mr. Vivek is very happy in a function of his friends. So you are at a good wavelength. And once I think you are out of service, then that wavelength gets strengthened also. I don't know how much of patience you have, but I tried to mark out some. Although there are many things which, but I will just read out some of the portions of the book which I thought may give a bit of an insight into what actually he has written and what he wants to. It's a recall of his working style and a small section comprising two persons was set up in the personal branch of the commissioner to diarize in a separate register the receipt of important letters marked as M, referenced by the commissioner, and with follow-up action for timely disposal. Instructions were issued separately to dispose of the references within 15 days, with any unexplained delay leading to appropriate action against the official concerned. This, I found, was an effective tool in facilitating expeditious disposal of references and settlement of public grievances permanently and quickly. So that speaks about the meticulous approach that the man who has written the book had. Then there is another paragraph about putting the brakes on the wasteful expenditure. There would be a huge rush, particularly towards the end of the financial year, to organize such functions. This would entail not only the cost of the stone or the metallic plaque, but other related expenditures too, such as the printing of invitation cards, erecting the shamiana with furniture arrangements, and organizing snacks, lunch or dinner. Each function costs the corporation anything between 20,000 to 50,000 or even more in some cases, depending on the status of the VIP invited for the ceremony. So it is heartening to note that a commissioner is thinking about that, is recalling that it was decided to put into place a foolproof system bereft of manual involvement, which could automatically ensure that the status of attendance is appraised regularly. So this, I think this
biometric
system, biometric and all was probably introduced during your time. So I have heard of the roller compacted concrete road constructed along the coast in Mumbai that was able to successfully withstand the fury of floods, which were accentuated by storms in the sea. Although the cost of the building of building such a road would be higher, it would be offset by almost no requirement of maintenance for at least 15 to 20 years, unless the road is cut off mechanically for laying down pipelines for public utilities or so on. There are many things which I wanted to, but I have just putting a few. So you get it, because you have to, your duty is not over by only coming to this function. You have to purchase this book also. And I have to help him in ensuring that you feel like purchasing it. Upholding the rule of law. So there is a couple of sentences here. The revenue secretary spoke to me on the phone and expressed his displeasure regarding the completion certificate, which had not been issued even as the building was slated to be inaugurated by the finance minister in the following couple of days. I explained the deficiencies in the building and advised the revenue secretary to call off the inaugural program of the building, which would save the government some possible embarrassment. The construction agency of the government should have been careful in ensuring compliance of the provisions of the bylaws. Instead of taking it for granted that a government building would in any case pass the test of scrutiny, the loss to the exchequer in such cases is incalculable, and the building may not be safe and habitable. The officers of the MCD were complimented for their stand and for upholding the rule of law. In the end, fair play is always rewarded. And this is a chapter on cracking the whip, tackling civil issues. And here in the paragraph about management of sanitation infrastructure, the Department of Environment Management Services of the MCD, which looks after the management of MSW, was mismanaged. The department is equipped with suitable infrastructure for waste management, including heavy vehicles, workshops for the repair of such vehicles, and stores for keeping the equipment and tools. However, the workshops for the repair of the garbage clearing vehicles had become storehouses of old, redundant, and unusable vehicles. When I visited the workshops, I found them enveloped in chaos. A standard operating procedure was needed to be put in place, as it would lay down the maximum time allowed for various kinds of repairs and also help optimize the cost of repairs through appropriate inventory management. So this gives you an idea about to what extent he had gone into the issues while being a commissioner. Then in the same chapter, roads and water logging, a recurrent problem, we are all very much familiar with that. The primary cause of water logging is the inadequacy in the city's network of 18 storm water drains or nalas carrying water from all over the city into the Yamuna, which moves with full force after heavy rains. However, the level of water in the Yamuna is in the 22 kilometer stretch through Delhi also rises steadily as more and more water is released from the neighboring state of Haryana, which regulates the release of water as and when required to save the adjoining villages in the upper reaches from getting inundated. As the water level in the river rises, storm water from the city cannot flow into the river. With a view to preventing the river water from entering the city, sluice gates were installed at the mouths of the nalas. The upkeep of the drain, which is under the control of the local bodies, needs to be assigned to the Delhi Sanitation Task Force. This is another idea that he has given in this. An agency proposed to be set up on the lines of the Delhi Metro Rail Corporation Limited. Then collapsing public health infrastructure, he says, the MCD provides healthcare facilities through 6 major hospitals and a large number of dispensaries spread over the entire area of its jurisdiction. Additionally, there is the need to reconstruct almost all the buildings which seem to have been impulsively constructed, almost as an afterthought. The conditions of the other hospitals of the corporation are also not very encouraging. The building infrastructure of all the hospitals is required to be upgraded and augmented to meet the growing requirements in a time-bound manner. This is necessary to improve the services being provided in the outpatient departments as well as the services in the wards for the patients admitted in the hospitals. The idea to set up a medical college under the corporation had been under consideration for quite some time. The unique aspect of setting up the medical college related to the in-house planning and execution done by the officers of the corporation, which made for a case study to be taught in management schools. The Hindu Rao Medical College is one of the most recent feathers in the glorious cap of the MCD. So he has in fact delved into virtually every subject, as has been said. Then in the same chapter, for the roofless, that shows his concern for these poor people. Multitudes of homeless and helpless residents of the city are compelled to occupy public spaces and live there temporarily and then permanently. The state makes arrangements by setting up temporary as well as permanent night shelters with separate segments for men and women. There is, however, always a shortage of space, as the requirement keeps on fluctuating depending on the weather conditions. The state provides facilities in the night shelters such as drinking water, water coolers, beds, dairies, blankets, first aid boxes, fire extinguishers, etc. There are separate arrangements for children, families, differently abled persons and women. Then he goes on to describe in detail about various PLs and all. A multipurpose building would, however, need to be well secured with a high-level boundary wall and with CCTVs installed at critical points to keep a constant vigil on the happenings inside the building. The CEO of the Delhi Urban Shelter Improvement should be made responsible for ensuring the use of such shelters only for a bona fide purpose. Please tell me when your patience is... But does that mean that I should? Then he is talking about this is in the next chapter, uncommon challenges of the Commonwealth Games, public conveniences. The surging crowds in front of the New Delhi railway station need public conveniences. To handle the volume of discharge, washrooms and toilets of appropriate capacity were constructed. Toilets developed by the Defence Research and Development Organisation of the Ministry of Defence were set up at Nigambodh Ghat. These toilets had been designed and developed for the army personnel posted at Siachen. The conventional toilets were therefore repaired and space was created on the walls in front of the toilets or urinals for commercial advertisements with a view to involving the private sector through the PPP scheme. Then about regularizing vendors and hawkers, he says the shopkeepers do not own the public spaces in front of their shops and they need to keep the areas free of encroachments. There is therefore a need to protect the hawkers from being fleeced by anyone, including the employees of the regulatory departments of the government or the local body. It is necessary to encourage the creation of self-employment opportunities and regulate their activities in the larger public interest. Then it's about the surprise inspections. The periodical inspections with the view to ascertaining the status and progress of the various schemes and programs of the regular works of the local bodies serve a useful purpose as they provide first-hand knowledge of the work being done on the ground. They also instill a sense of confidence and involvement in the official run down the line. The surprise element in inspection reveals the true picture of the way the work is progressing on the ground. Then there are some very beautiful pictures of his some beautiful leaders. Implementing the reforms agenda. This is about digital initiatives. So today we talk so much about Digital India, and Prime Minister has done so much about the Digital India. He wants everything to be inside a phone, and he has got most of the things inside the phone now in the last 5 years. So the corporation became the first public authority in the country to manage all transactions pertaining to outdoor advertisement through an online system. Starting with the initiation of the biometric system for marking attendance of the regular as well as substitute employees, to going online for tax payment, to easing pressure on provision of civic services, transparency and transformation were achieved in every sphere of working of the MCD. MCD goes online. The e-tendering application system has passed the test of time. I think this is some of the very good things that you have done. Same is the case with the online submission of property tax and factory licensing. The health information system has been of enormous use to better hospital administration and patient care. The MCD is the first organization in India to have made the right to information application online. I think not many people know that this was all done during his tenure. Then in the same reforms agenda, this is about waste management. The state of the capital compelled initiatives to be taken in waste management, which included setting up of compost plants and waste to energy plants. Compost plants were set up at Okhla, 200 metric ton, Bhalaswa 300 metric ton, and Narela APMC 100 metric ton, while waste to energy plants were also set up at Okhla, 2,050 tons per day, and Ghazipur 1,300 tons per day. The waste to energy plant set up in Okhla is India's first such facility, which is also registered with the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change for earning carbon credits. Then is there is a chapter in the towards the end of the book that's about redefining urban governance, and they are talking about public inconveniences. He says there are around 644 slum clusters in Delhi with only 473 functional toilets. The result: railway tracks serve as toilets for lakhs of people who reside in slum clusters. These tracks are the sites for open defecation, urination and garbage dumping, leading to ghastly sights and conditions. The railway tracks should be entrenched by boundary walls of an appropriate height on both sides up to the city limits, and the space on the surface of the boundary walls so created can be utilized for commercial use. Then in the same chapter, this is about setting up of the Delhi Sanitation Task Force. An agency known as the Delhi Sanitation Task Force should be created as a limited company. The agency will be a separate entity with members in its growing body from the Government of India, Government of NCT of Delhi and the local bodies. It is considered necessary to hive off collection of garbage and all subsequent operations from the MCD to the DSTF, an autonomous corporation to be formed on the lines of the Delhi Metro Rail Corporation. The DSTF shall be responsible for the collection of garbage from the households and its transportation to the processing sites. Then further in this chapter, it is also considered necessary to audit the performance of the Safai Karamcharis of the local bodies through the civil society by appointing a committee for each area on a rotational basis. The name and designation of the sanitation staff need to be displayed on a board in each area. The audit team would report the performance of the sanitation staff online on a regular basis. Then This is the last chapter, I think. There's one more. Last chapter, Go Green for a Better Tomorrow. Master plan for drainage. The management of sewage and storm water is another important area which needs to be effectively addressed for an unpolluted city. Almost 60% of the untreated sewage gets dumped into the Yamuna, thus translating into nearly 500 MGD. There is a need to optimally utilize the installed capacity of the sewage treatment plants by simultaneously expanding the capacity to bridge the gap. This will help provide treatment facilities of sewage being generated in the entire city. Thankfully, the Master Plan 2031 prepared by the Delhi Jal Board has a proposal scheme to lay a 9,807 kilometer long sewer line with more than 100 pumping stations and around 38 sewerage treatment plants at a cost of 10,077 crores. In case water is not regularly lifted and pumped, the entire East Delhi would get inundated. There is therefore a strong case for filling the depressions in East Delhi to bring the ground level in this entire part of Delhi above the level of trunk drains, saving the Yamuna. Just a couple of lines more. Unless Delhi is clean, Yamuna can never be clean. I think that's a very important statement. It is a sad fact that Delhi contributes 79% of the total pollution load into Yamuna River, even as the stretch of river in Delhi is only 2% of the total length of the river. The setting up of an interceptor system to trap the sludge and other pollution material from these major drains, Nazafgarh, Supplementary and Shadra, is a beginning in the right direction. The proposal of DJB to treat the sewage by bioremediation through activated wetlands and a series of floating wetlands needs to be pursued and implemented on priority. Then there is a very beautiful picture of the man. And here, on the end, my observation, my comments in brief are there. In detail are also here. And Kapil Sibbal ji's comments are also here. So I think that makes a good story for all of you to purchase the book today itself. Kyo saab? So, thank you all for a... Yes, sir. Whatever he writes in the book, we will do, don't worry. In his next book, let him write that in his next book. I am open to anything, any good suggestion given by anyone in Delhi, not a officer, but even a layman, if he gives me a good suggestion, we will implement it. No, it's a good idea, I think. Thanks everybody. I think we can, Delhi is such a big Pandora's box now that we can talk and talk and talk and talk and it can never finish. But the issue is that we must ensure that one day comes when we have an end to all these issues. And I think the, as far as I can see, a lot of the great officers who are residing in Delhi, they have spent all their life in Delhi. If they put their mind, heart, soul, brain, intellectual acumen together, they can bring us a new book with a good quality, implementable solutions to all the daily problems. And we promise you that with the help of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, irrespective of whichever government is there, we'll see that we implement all of them in Delhi. Thank you so much.